Namaste. Welcome to my channel, Mastering Public Procurement. This is a second video in the series of videos on Department of Expenditure's model tender document. In the last video, we had talked about the development of these MTDs. And in this video, we will talk about how to customize these MTDs to make it MTDs specific to your organization. My earlier videos links are there in the end of the video and also at the description below the videos. DOI's MTDs are generic and many variables are written as generic placeholders occurring at many places throughout the MTD and its headers. To convert these MTDs as your organization's specific MTDs, one-time replacement of generic placeholders with values specific to your organization has to be done so that the specific MTD of your organization can be used for all your procurement. This replacement is not to be done at each individual occurrence of the placeholder throughout the MTD, but can be done only once at one go by use of a Word software procedure. All occurrences will then automatically get changed at all the places. This procedure has been explained in the guidance note for each MTD. And where are the guidance note? The guidance note is included in the PDF version of these MTDs in the DOE's website, the link of which is given in the description below the video and also in the link at in the circular place here. If you please click this circular place, you'll get the card for link to the DOE's website for PDF version. Let us discuss what is the Word software procedure. Word document has a feature called fields properties. We can see them in the Word document. If we go to the insert tab, then the quick parse tab, and then the fields tab within the quick parse pop-up. One category of fields used in the Word is called the document property, or doc property in short. Some of the doc properties are assigned by Word for specific use, like author, date of publishing, etc. We cannot touch them. There are custom doc properties designed in these MTDs to hold variables as placeholders, which may be customized for each organization. Before we proceed, please write down the variables and decide on appropriate replacement for your organization as used in the current tender documents. Before we go there, let me show you the doc properties. Where are they? We will go to the Word document, which is like this. So here, if you go to the insert tab, you will have quick parts here, and here there are the document properties, and these are used by Word. These are abstract, author, category, etc. But in generally the fields are here, and this drop down menu shows the number of fields, number category of fields which are in the Word document. One of the category on the second page is the doc property. On the right hand side, all the doc properties, those used by the Word software as well as used in this document, are listed. But we cannot change the custom doc properties in the way we have shown. There is a separate procedure. Before we go to the procedure, let us see what are the custom variables you have to give specific value. There are 7 variables which you have to modify for the organizations as a whole. The name of the doc property is procuring organization. It is the name of your organization, and the existing placeholder throughout the document is using procuring organization. Similarly, procuring entity is the office within your organization which is issuing the tender, and the placeholder is procuring entity. Next doc property is on behalf of. This is the authority in whose name the contract is entered into. In case of central government, this is President of India. which is kept as the existing placeholder. Then the legal head of your procuring organization is the designation who normally appoints arbitration as per the tender document. The placeholder is head of procuring organization. You can replace it by the name of the head of your organization. For example, in PSU, you will call him chairman and managing director. Head of procurement is another doc property, which is actually the head of the procurement division, say controller of stores, etc. And the existing placeholder is head of procurement. E-procurement portal is the portal on which you will be uploading the bid documents. We have kept the placeholders as the CPP URL. Tender inviting authority is the officer who actually uploads and liaises with the procurement portal, and this procurement portal calls it tender inviting authority or TI. There are two doc properties which will be customized in each procurement, not in the organization's MTD. So, and these are document number, which is the tender reference number. The present value is tender number.xxxx, and subject matter of procurement is the short title of the procurement, which will go in the tender title. Presently, we have called it goods. So now let us see the procedure. We will do a trial customization using a specific file of the MTD. This exercise is being shown for goods MTD, but it is same for non-consultancy MTD also. First of all, please download the Word file of the goods MTD from the DOE's website. The link is given in the description below the video. And also in this place, we have a circular part where if you click, the drop-down menu will open and show you the link from where you can get the Word file. After downloading, create a copy of this and rename it suitable for your organization. I have called it Our Goods MTD so that you do not spoil the downloaded file. Open this renamed file and follow the procedure shown in the video. We will switch to the Word file now to do the trial customization for a fictitious PSU with the following specific variables. For organization, we will call Bharat EV Limited. For procuring entity, we will call Materials Department. We will, on behalf of, we will say CMD, and the legal head is CMD. Procuring entity head is Materials Head, and the TIA is Deputy Manager Materials. So let us get going. We will switch over to the Word file. In the Word file, you will find that this tab is there, File, on the left hand side. Click this, then it will show you in the left panel information. This info, click this, it will show you further two panels, left panel and the right panel. We are interested in the right panel where property is written. Property has a drop down feature showing the advanced property. We are interested in advanced property. Let us go to advanced property by clicking it. This drop down pop-up will open up, and this is the custom tab in this. Let us open the custom tab, and here are the list of all the specific custom doc properties used in this MTD. So let us start with the procuring organization. This is the procuring organization. Here is the name of the doc property. This is text, therefore it is type text. This is the value presently given in the MTD. So we'll change it to Bharat EV Limited. So we'll now click, after changing it, we'll click modify. We have more clicks to do, and let us do procuring entity. The second one, procuring entity, this is the name of the doc property. This is the present value. We'll change this value to Materials Department, and Materials Department, and then we'll modify that. And next property we will do is on behalf. Here the on behalf of, the present value is President of India. Here we will write chairman and managing director. So this we will do it, and again modify. This goes chairman and modify. Then we will have the legal head, that is the person who will be appointing the arbitrators. We'll just simply, for ease, just write CMD and modify. The next person is the head of procurement, that is the head of materials department. Here we write material head. Modify that. Now we are left with procurement head. Now we are left with tender inviting authority. So tender inviting authority present value is this. We'll just write here deputy manager materials and modify that. So all the custom doc properties have been modified, but the document is still not yet changed. We just say okay here so that all this is converted into the Word software. It gets placed in the Word software when we say okay. Still the document will show older values. For example, if we go to the NIT, we will see what are the NIT still showing. NIT is still showing president of it. So to populate the new custom properties, we'll have to say select all. So this whole text of the document has been selected, and we have to press function button and F9 together. I'm pressing F function and then F9. So now it is going through, it is asking update page numbers only. I'll say okay here because the table of content is also the fields. So all the fields are getting changed. Now you see, instead of President of India, Chairman and Managing Director has come, materials has come of the materials department, and the name of the organization has become Bharat EV Limited, and the other things have not changed, the description, tender, and the tender number. We will do it in the each procurement, not in the model tender document of the organization. Let us save this so that all the changed variables are now in this file. So we have completed the population of the changed doc properties throughout the tender doc. So this has now become your organization's model tender document. And now the way forward is, please look out for the next two videos where we will show how the MTD of your organization is to be customized for each specific procurement. As we had seen in the earlier video of the development of MTDs, we had seen that the present MTDs are for a specific type of procurement. If your procurement is of a different type, you need to customize it to match the type of procurement you are doing. Besides that, you'll also need to enter the details of each procurement, and we will handle those in the next two videos. But before we go, let us see what are the present procurement for which MTD is designed and what we can customize it. We have discussed this in detail in the earlier video. The present MTD is for open tenders through JIPNIC e-procurement. It is single stage two cover procurement method, and it is for general goods in goods. And in services MTD, it is for input administration type of contracts. It can be customized to single cover procurement, or second stage of two stage procurement, or for PQB, or for rate contract in goods, and retainership and on-call type of contract for service. It can be also customized for global tenders and tender cum reverse auction type of procurements. For goods, it can be customized for capital goods or annual running contracts or AMC type of things. But for services, it can be customized for other forms of contracts other than the input and measurement type of contracts. So this is all for this video. In the next two videos, we will see how this organization's specific MTD is to be customized for each procurement if it is using a different procurement method, and how to fill the details. Thank you for watching Mastering Public Procurement and this video. Before you go, please click like, share the video with your friends, and click the subscribe button as given above. Thank you. once again